Welcome to my channel MK MediGuide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy.
For today, our topic is drug-receptor interactions, or how the drug and receptor form a complex, or simply how the drug binds to the receptor. Nowadays, most of the drugs show effect by binding to receptors. First, the drug binds to the receptor and then they form a complex which then activate intracellular responses which results in effect of the drug. So, for a drug to show pharmacological action through the receptors, it is necessary for the drug to bind with the receptor by chemical forces or by forming a chemical bond. And after the formation of the chemical bond, the receptor undergoes conformational changes, and thus the receptor is said to be activated by drugs, which is responsible for the drug effect on the body. So for this purpose, different drugs may form various types of bonds with the receptor. The receptors are mostly protein in nature, and some studies show that a minimum of 3-point attachment of the drug with the receptor is required for its activation. Besides this, a drug with agonistic activity activates the receptor rather than antagonist. There are mainly three types of bonds which a drug forms with the receptor, which is covalent bond, electrostatic bond, and hydrophobic bond. So, first, what is covalent bond? Well, these types of bonds between drug and receptors are very strong as compared to electrostatic bonds and hydrophobic bonds. And these types of bonds are not reversible under physiological condition, means inside the body, because the drug and receptor forms a very stable complex with each other. Thus, the drug cannot be dissociated from the receptor inside the body. These types of bonds are formed due to the mutual sharing of electrons between drug and no receptor. And that's why most of the drug nowadays are weak acids or weak bases, means to have some charges on it. In this bonds, the drugs are unable to make that strong linkage, mean covalent bond with the receptor. And thus, the poisoning of these drugs can be easily overcome as they form mostly a reversible bond with the receptor. So, the drugs which form these types of bond with the receptors include the acetyl group of aspirin with cyclooxygenase enzymes, and proton pump inhibitors bonding with the hydrogen potassium ATPase, and phenicillins. And more importantly, some poisons make these types of bonds with the receptors. Moreover, the action of these compounds do not depend on half-life and minimum effective concentration of the drug in the body. They are often fully eliminated, mean disappeared from the blood, but still have their effect on the body due to its strongly bonded molecules with the receptors. And the drug effect only diminishes with the synthesis of new receptors, which may take time from hours to days. For example, when PPIs blocks the hydrogen potassium ATPase, this transporter needs 24 hours to re-establish and do its normal functioning. The second type is electrostatic bonds. These types of bonds are formed due to the attraction between different charges. These types of bonds are weak than covalent, and mostly they are reversible, which are more common than covalent bonds. These types of bonds are mostly reversible in nature. Electrostatic bonds are subdivided into ionic bonds, hydrogen bonds, and van der Waal forces. The first one is ionic bond. These types of drug-receptor interactions occur due to the difference in the ionic property of the drug and receptors, and thus they attract each other, which make a bond, which are strong linkage compared to hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces. Different ionic properties means the one would have a positive charge and the other would have a negative charge, and thus they attract each other and form a bond which is reversible in nature. The receptor would be functional until the drug dissociates again from it. The drugs which forms these types of bond with the receptors include nicotine and acetylcholine bonding with acetylcholine esterase enzyme. With this, the next topic is a hydrogen bond. Well, hydrogen bonding with the receptors occurs in those drugs in which a hydrogen is attached to a most electronegative atom like oxygen and nitrogen, which attracts the electron toward itself and makes the hydrogen partially deficient of electrons. And thus, the hydrogen atom becomes partially positive, while the most electronegative atom becomes partially negative charged. Now, when the receptor has the same phenomena, then the different folds of the drug and receptor will attract each other in such a manner that it forms a bond which is stronger than van der Waals forces and weaker than ionic bonding. Besides this, this phenomena also occurs when the receptor has a permanent charge on it, and thus it will attract the opposite fold of the drug and would form a reversible bond. The drugs which forms these types of bonds with the receptor include nicotine and L-isoproterenol. With this, the last type of electrostatic bonding is van der Waals forces. These types of bond formation between drug and receptors are very weak as compared to hydrogen bonding and ionic bonding. These types of interaction occur between N-O drug and receptors, that is, the drug and receptor has no charges on it, mean the number of electrons and protons are equal in both of it, and thus don't have any apparent charges. In this case, when the drug and receptors comes in close contact with each other, they form temporary induced dipoles in each other due to the attraction and repulsion of electrons and protons in both of them. And thus, the opposite dipoles attract each other for a very short duration of time. And thus, a bond is formed which is not stable and breaks very quickly. The drug deattaches from the receptor. For example, nicotine, which also forms these types of bonds with its receptor. As we discussed before, a single drug can form more than one bonds with the receptor to activate it. The last types of bonds in this discussion, which drugs forms with the receptors, are hydrophobic bonds. These types of bonds are mostly formed by the drugs, which form a complex with the intracellular receptors, in which the chemical nature of the drug and receptors are different than the surrounded medium, because the surrounded medium have a polar nature, while the drug and receptor have a non-polar nature. And thus, in this polar system, these non-polar drug and receptors tends to come in contact with each other, to have minimal contact with the polar molecules, and thus it attracts each other, which forms a bond which is known as hydrophobic bond. And these types of bonds are relatively stronger than hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces. The drugs which forms a hydrophobic bond with its receptors and shows response, include all steroids, which is corticosteroids, dexamethasone, prednisolone, etc., and spironolactone, which has antagonistic activity. Moreover, phospholipid bilayer also maintains its shape and rigidity due to these types of bonds between the macromolecules of the cell membrane. And with this, thanks for watching our video and support us by subscribing our channel.